Have you noticed that people all over the country have started to go out completely for little or no reason? People get fiercely angry, even on very minor issues, and you never know when someone might explode. You might be talking to a moderately soft middle-aged woman for a moment, and the next moment could turn into a violent Karen. And of course, I don't particularly choose women, because most of the people involved in the violent uprisings we have seen across the country in recent weeks were men. People of all ages and backgrounds suddenly go crazy completely. And what we have experienced so far is just the beginning. The mainstream media deserve many crimes for this. They say that the uprisings that happen every night in our big cities are peaceful. And they tell us over and over again, but everyone can see that they are not. In Portland, protesters regularly fire bullets, destroy buildings and fire, and continue to escape from it. Apart from Fox News, major news organizations in this country have given their full confirmation of what these rebels are doing, which sends a very dangerous signal to everyone. If it is perfectly acceptable for the rebels to attack police officers, destroy buildings, and carry out other acts of violence because they are disturbed by the system, then many young people outside will allow themselves to explode violently, broken by something. For example, there was an accident in Tennessee where only hundreds of young people started a violent attack at the mini golf center because game machines ate their cash. A Tennessee mini golf center erupted in chaos Saturday night when 300 to 400 teenagers began terrorizing staffers and smashing up the premises because the game machines ate their cash, Gem Press reported. The riotous scene at Put-Put Fun Center at Golf and Games Family Park in Memphis was caught on camera by an alarmed bystander and shows the violent teens go berserk and throw various heavy objects at stuff because they did not issue the kids a refund. The video, which went viral on Twitter, focuses primarily on one young girl who helped kick off the stampede when she shoved a plexiglass screen from the counter, causing it to cave in on stuffers as they hid behind ATM machines in fear. She then proceeds to throw two more plexiglass partitions and rips out a computer screen before moving to heavier, more dangerous objects like metal retractable belt barriers. The teen is seen hurling the metal pole across the counter while a blood-curdling scream echoes throughout the space. Others joined in the tormenting by flinging napkin holders at the workers. The girl then picks up another belt barrier to toss before exciting the camera frame. To really feel this event, you need to see some video footage, and someone posted a short clip of chaos on Twitter here. 100 years ago, young people in the United States would never behave like this. And this is more evidence of how dramatically our culture has deteriorated. On the East Coast, three men, Karens, were completely mad, and when they were told that they came too late to buy food, a bagel shop damaged $13,000. Footage released by police shows the suspects smashing up the Brothers Deli and Bagel in Dyker Heights, Brooklyn at around 5:30 p.m. on Friday, after workers had packed up and were waiting for their delivery man to bring the bikes inside. The video shared Tuesday shows the would-be customers knocking drinks off a shelf, flipping over snacks, and turning tables after seemingly realizing they were too late to buy food. One of the men kicked the display counter inside the shop near 71st Street. A worker at the Mexican family run deli claims the suspects also broke a meat slicing machine and threw an ATM on the floor. That day, we were ready to close actually. We were closed and I was waiting for my delivery guy to bring the bikes inside. And these two guys came inside and started to break everything inside. Hedger Morales, 35, who works at the deli with three of his brothers, told the New York Post. Morales doesn't appear in the clip as he went to the back to call police after they started causing damage. In a civilized society, people solve their differences calmly and peacefully, but the truth is that we are less civilized every day. For many people, resorting to violence becomes the number one option, and talking rationally is at the bottom of the list. In South Florida, no one is sure why a group of people in swimsuits started to punch each other at a local casino, but it made headlines all over the world. Three people were arrested and several more were banned from a South Florida casino after they were filmed in a violent brawl. Video on social media shows several individuals wearing bathing suits while pummeling each other inside the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and casino in Hollywood on Friday. The video went viral, generating more than 4 million views as of Monday afternoon. At this point, the fight video has been seen more than 4 million times, and I think this should not be a surprise to any of us. While recording this podcast, several lines came to mind in the New Testament written by the Apostle Paul. This know also that in the last days perilous times shall come, for men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemous, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than lovers of God, having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof, from such turn away. Everywhere you look, we are starting to see that people are extremely angry. And Americans anger, their anger with frightening regularity. And if things are that bad anyway, that will the US look like when things really get out of control? The way we raise and raise our children is really important. For decades, most of the country has completely expelled all forms of traditional morality, and we believed that they could define our children as right and wrong as they wish. Our education system is a complete and complete joke. Most children were raised without a real moral foundation, and our culture relentlessly puts a victim mentality in the heads of young people. A society is only as strong as the sum of the individuals that make up it, and the lack of character in US at this time is absolutely frightening. Yes, there are certainly many exceptions. I know really great people, but I wish there were much more. Unfortunately, the social deterioration that eats in our society like a cancer is getting worse with each passing year. Decades of incredibly bad decisions have brought us into this point, and there is no indication that our nation will choose a different road soon. Most of idea, comment, information, and criticism containing in these videos have been created by Daily News Report. Before making any important investment decision, use the information contained in these videos as a starting point for conducting your own research. If you make any investment or legal decision, it is advised to consult an expert before making this decision.